Good morning. It's day 14 of virtual learning at TD Christian. Today I'm going to lead you in devotions. I'm pretty excited to do so. I know that we're 14 days into it, and I know that there's a lot that we can think about what's happening, about what has happened and what's going to happen. I just want to encourage you today about the greatness of God, and I want to encourage you with a song that comes from a song that I knew when I was younger and that has been changed to a newer version today. So I'm going to share the screen now and tell you a little bit about that and where it comes from. Devos, Day 14. Psalm 121 is a psalm of ascents. It's what the pilgrims used to recite on their way up to Jerusalem. It's got 8 verses. I look up to the mountains. Does my help come from there? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not let you or me stumble. The one who watches over us will not slumber. Indeed, who watches over Israel never slumbers or sleeps. The Lord himself watches over you, over us. The Lord stands beside you as your protective shade. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon at night. The Lord keeps you from all harm and watches over your life. The Lord keeps watch over you as you come and go, both now and forever. These are incredible words that I wanted to share with you today. And they inspired a song a number of years ago called How Great Thou Art. And out of that song comes a song called How Great You Are. It was written by Carl Boberg, a Swedish composer in the early 1900s. It's translated in many languages, including Russian. And a Ukrainian missionary named Stuart Hine heard it and translated it into English in 1949. And from there, it became one of the greatest hymns in Christianity. And sometimes when I see the stars, when I see the sky, when I hear thunder or lightning, I'm reminded of God's greatness in creation. But also, as we look back at Easter, I'm also reminded in God's goodness in giving us a Savior, Jesus Christ. And I look forward to the glorification as we have life eternal in Him. Inspired by this song in 2012, Joel and Pat Shezbel wrote How Great You Are. So it took the language of How Great Thou Art and changed the tune and presented it in a really wonderful way. And I want to share that with you at this time. And while we're doing that, I'd like to say, what's the point of all this? God uses people and circumstances for His glory and purposes. I don't know why COVID-19 is here, but I do know that God will use people and circumstances to make something good come out of this, to make something wonderful happen. I'm not sure how or why. And that's why I ask, why not us now? As we take on this adventure of virtual learning, as we take on the adventure of life, we can ask ourselves, why not use us, Lord, now for your purposes? He is great, and we are called to follow. That's what I want to urge you today as you listen to this song and as you view this incredible photo by Mr. Sharda of the galaxies. And the refrain goes, my soul must sing to you an offering, how great you are. My soul must sing, oh, let the heavens ring, how great you are, oh, how great you are. May you be inspired by that today. And as I finish here with a prayer, we'll roll into the actual song itself. Let's pray together as we see this incredible photo that talks of God's greatness and might. Thank you, Lord, for your incredible power. We thank you for your might and for how great you are. Now that's inspired people over the centuries to praise you. Lord, many of us have experienced trouble, and for many of us, this is a great difficult situation. For others, oh Lord, it's an adventure. And we pray, Lord, that we may see it as an adventure in you. For you are great and you have asked us to follow. Help us to take steps in faith. We pray especially, Lord, for those who are struggling at this time. It's been 14 days or 13 days of virtual learning, and that's hard for many of us as teachers, as staff members, as school, as parents, as community. But we know, Lord, that you are leading and guiding, and we trust that you will give us that strength again this day. We pray, Lord, for the many who are working in places where there is unrest or uncertainty, especially with COVID-19, those who are hoping to get surgeries but cannot because of the pandemic. We pray, Lord, for those who are serving others, that they may also be kept safe. We think especially, Lord, of places in our own communities where this is occurring. We pray for the people in Holland Christian Homes. We pray, Lord, for other people in different nursing homes and circumstances as they are cared for by people who are afraid, who are concerned. And as we pray for those who are quarantined, will you give them your strength and your nearness, your love and your hope as well. We pray, Lord, for a good day this day, that we may rejoice in you. And as we hear the song, How Great You Are, we may be reminded of how you have created us, this world, how you use us for your purposes, and how you will have promised us through your Son, Jesus Christ, that we might live with you forever. We come to you in his name. Amen. Have a great day and enjoy the song.
Well, good morning, everybody, and thank you again, Mr. Groot, for doing devotions and sharing that song with us. I'm wearing my Feyenoord soccer jersey today because one of the things that we have coming up as a school is a school-wide virtual jersey day. So that will be next Wednesday, and we'll have many more announcements coming up for that. And also just make sure we're paying attention to the different announcements on Edsby there from Mr. Buwalda, as he's looking for lots of help in planning this year's yearbook. One of the ways that you can do that is tomorrow, during the day, we are asking that you will fill out your yearbook survey. And it's basically just a questionnaire. The link will be in the announcements where you can answer a bunch of questions and help with the creation of the yearbook. So thank you for that as well. We're going to move on in the assembly today. And the next thing that is coming up is a video from this year's ComTech class.
For so long, I've been so preoccupied with spending time with you. It was an obsession that I'm not proud of. But things have changed. I want to see the world with my eyes wide open. You're blocking my vision, but now it's time to see clearly. The past years have been good, but I didn't realize how toxic this relationship was. Now I can tell that we just don't connect anymore. We had something, but it's gone. It's time for me to move on. I'm sorry, this is just so emotional for me. It's over now. I could do this. The first step was admitting that I was powerless over my technology. I had an awakening and I'm casting it away.
Wow, it's a timely video. I don't know about you, but my weekly screen time reports from Apple have not been pretty over the last 4 weeks. So again, thank you, class, and thank you for sharing that message with us. That is pretty much it for the assembly today. Remember, next Wednesday is Druze Day. Before we go, I thought we'd leave you with a check-in on Marg. I know a lot of you are probably wondering what she's doing lately, so we will check in with Marg, and then have a great day.
Hey, what's going on over there? What's up, Marg? You're making all this noise. Haven't you done attendance yet?
I did it. There's nobody here.
Oh, no, she's in the mirror.